Welcome to Plugged In and Turned On in Paradise, highlighting hidden musical talents, singer-songwriters, and musicians that are standing on the world stages only a few steps from your favorite musical megastars. Our series is filmed at Clayville, a Northern California recording studio nestled in the beautiful foothills of Paradise. Each episode features a variety of top players rehearsing and performing in live musical mashups. And since many are world-class music insiders, they have stories to tell, giving our viewers an intimate peek into their intriguing lives, sharing the big stage with megastars.
When I was 70 years old, I was in a singing group. I was the youngest one in the group. The group was called Four of a Kind. And I've been doing it ever since. Can't stop now. I'm addicted.
Tony Lindsay has been the frontman and lead vocalist for Santana for over two decades, garnering a dozen Grammys during that time. His voice is one you've heard singing on Dancing with the Stars as the show's longtime featured vocalist, or at the San Francisco Giants and 49er games, or maybe you've heard him gracing countless commercials for America's top brands, or at the Super Bowl halftime show. One thing's for sure, Tony Lindsay is everywhere. His golden voice has been sought out by many other artists and producers for recordings and live performances. He has sung alongside musical acts such as Curtis Mayfield, Tower of Power, The OJs, Al Jarreau, Steve Winwood, Johnny Gill, Teddy Pendergrass, Aretha Franklin, Lou Rawls, and the New York Philharmonic. Tony is also an accomplished solo artist in his own right, and his single, Crushed, is currently rising in radio charts around the world.
Don't you come back no more. What you say, hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back no more. That woman, oh woman, don't you treat me so mean. The meanest woman that I've ever seen. I guess if you say so,
that's right.
I ought to pack my bags and go. That's right. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more.
So how long have you been a professional musician?
Oh my God, since I was 7 years old. I started doing this at a very young age. We had a cappella singing group called Four of a Kind. My childhood was in New York, upstate New York.
Yeah?
Yeah, Kingston, New York.
Wow.
Right by Woodstock.
And when did you leave?
1980 is when I moved to California. And I love New York. I like to go to visit, but I really like California.
Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more. What you say, hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back no more.
Hey, I said, baby, oh baby, don't you treat me this way. Cause I'll be back on my feet someday.
Do good, you ain't no good. You ain't got no money and you ain't no good, baby.
Well, I guess if you say so, oh, oh, I had to pack my things and go.
That's right, hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back no more.
Yeah, what you say?
Yeah, hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, and don't
don't you come back no more.
Yeah, no more.
Highlights in your touring career, places you visited.
Oh my God!
On tour, that stand out for you.
That's a long list because of 25 years with Santana. I've been around the world probably at least 20 times.
With anyone who you consider one of your musical icons?
Stevie Wonder, definitely, in that in the 25 years with Santana, which is very interesting because here I grew up in Kingston, New York, which Woodstock is 8 miles from my hometown, and all the Santana stuff, Jimi Hendrix and all that was going on, and I didn't even know who those people were. I was so into the Temptations and Smokey Robinson and the Miracles and all the Motown scene and, you know, that kind of thing. And then we had a guitar player in the band that was backing us up that was totally into all the rock stuff, mm-hmm. Santana and all. And we started doing that stuff. And I started singing a lot of the Santana songs back then. I went, oh, that's kind of cool. And then flash forward, I don't know how many years, I end up being the lead singer with Santana. Like, it's kind of weird. There was a guy, Chester Thompson, keyboard player. He played with Tower of Power first, and after he left Tower, he went to Santana. And in a band that we had put together in San Jose, a group called Spangalang, the drummer, Ronnie Beck, was the drummer in Tower of Power. This one time he came and he said, hey man, you know, Santana's auditioning singers. He said, I'd like to throw your name in the pot if you were interested. Yeah, sure. I didn't think any more of it. And then I get a call from him saying, hey, you know, we have an audition on these days. And so I went and did the audition first. they sent me about four songs to Santana audition. We did two songs, and he went, "Nah, I don't need to hear anymore." I get home that night, and there's about eight messages on my answering machine from the Santana office. "Hey, call us back. Call me back. So I finally called back, and he said, "Dude, where you at?" I said, "Well, I'm at home now." He says, "Well, Carlos loved you. You know, if you want the gig, it's yours." I went, "Really?" And 25 years later, I was still there.
I used to work at this club in San Francisco that every time I went to the club, I never knew who the band was. Never knew who the players were, because the owner of the club used to call everybody individually and say, "Hey, are you available tonight on such and such a night?" So I would show up, had no idea what the band was, and didn't know what kind of music these guys knew. Yeah. So sometimes I go in there, and all these guys knew were R&B tunes, so we did that. Sometimes I go in, they knew nothing but straight ahead jazz, so it forced me to learn a lot of different stuff.
Yeah. I don't need no doctor, 'cause I know what's ailing me. I do. All I need is my baby, oh, to bring me out of misery. Oh, yeah, yeah. I don't need no doctor or prescription to be filled. No. I said, I don't need no doctor. One of those Viagra pills. No. All I need is my baby. Oh, that girl gives me such a thrill. Yeah. Hey, let me tell you what my doctor told me. Yes, and my doctor said I need a rest, but I need a tenderness. He put me on a critical list, one that didn't even exist. Gave me a medicated lotion, but it didn't soothe my emotion.
With Carlos Santana so long that I've been, you know, on the road a lot. So when I come home, I get to work with all the great people that live in the Bay Area. Everybody loves each other, and we get together, and you've seen it.
It's
we have a good
stuff.
Time. You need to move down here.
I'm down here a lot.
No, that's not the same.
I know.
See, because I was here last week, but you weren't here.
Yeah.
All my friends, fearless, they're appointed today. They keep trying to tell me, all you want to do is use me. In my shoes, baby, you just keep on using me.
Thank you.
feels this good getting you before you just keep on using me.
Speaking of playing with people that you really enjoy playing
yes.
with, you and Carlos
yes.
have had a long-standing relationship musically.
It's been a few years now. It's been great when you surround yourself with people that have talent like that. It raises you.
Right.
You know, you can't come out there jiving because they're going to kick your butt. I mean, when I was growing up in New York. I mean, some people would, come, hey, can we come and sit in? And this is when I was a young kid. And the older guys, would say, somebody would come in, and if they sat in, if they weren't doing what they should be doing, didn't do their homework, they would, bang, stop the band, get off the stage. And I mean, they would embarrass you like that. And I watched that happen to a lot of people, and I went, you know what? That's not gonna happen to me.
Everybody says that we are wrong. Oh, but who do they think they are to try to judge us? Simply because they think my color is wrong. You know we gotta find a way to bring some love in here today. I said picket lines, picket signs. Don't punish me with brutality. Talk to me. I know you all will see what's going on. What's going on? Wanna know what's going on?
So I make sure I just keep my act together and don't do any crazy stuff, and you got to take care of yourself. Yeah, we listen to each other. That's what you do when you play with people that know how to do this thing. We don't have time to teach people now. You got to do your homework and then come and hang with us.
Hey, everybody, let's have some fun. Only live but once, and when you're dead, you're done. So let the good times roll. Talking about the good times. I don't care if you're young or old. Ought to get together, let the good times roll. Now don't.
And 1980 is when I moved to California. And I haven't looked back since. It's so nice to get locked into the music scene around here. I'm starting to feel like I'm a big shot or something.
I think you kind of are.
It took a long time.
Where is the love? Said you'd give to me soon as you were free. Will it ever be? Where is the love? You told me that you didn't love him and you were gonna say goodbye. But if you really didn't mean it, why did you have to lie? Tell me, where is love?
you would tell me so. Don't leave me hanging on the promises. You got to let me
Otherwise, what's the point if we don't have a good time doing this and, you know, we're working at McDonald's or something? But I can't do that. I can't.
Tonight was freaking incredible, man. I mean, the combination with Carlos and Janice and you and, I mean, everybody. It was just, that was fun.
Great show.
That was a great show. Paradise.
People always ask me, do I ever get nervous? Mm-hmm. Like, I tell them, you know what? The bigger the audience for me, the better. Mm-hmm. If I'm singing and there's only like four or five people out there, I'm a little uncomfortable with that.
Hear that. I feel the same. Want to connect in the right way.
100,000 people is great.
So, this is my latest solo CD. Tony Lindsay, Something Beautiful, and it is something beautiful too. You need to get this because it's hot. Matter of fact, my first single on here, which is Sweet Love, that went number one on the indie soul chart. And the second single, which is playing now, which is the title of the CD, Something Beautiful, and that's probably gonna go number one too. So I got two songs coming off of here, and I'm gonna release a third and probably a fourth single because I got a lot of good stuff on this.
Okay, let's go. Three takes.
You're so lovely, don't you ever change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it, cause I love you, girl. Just the way that you look tonight. Oh, yeah. Oh, you're so lovely. Nobody's loved you, come rain or come shine.
It's definitely good. You know why? Because Tony Lindsay's on there. That's why it's good.
We hope you've enjoyed this show. Please give us your comments at ParadiseMusicHour.com. We'll be presenting another great artist next week on this public television station.